In this video, we're looking at a kinetic friction problem where we're pulling on a block by using a rope. We keep a tension of 68 newtons in that rope. And then in the first part of the problem, we pull perfectly horizontally with the rope and we want to find the acceleration of the block. And then in the second part, now we're pulling up at an angle of 40 degrees. And again, what we want is to compute the acceleration here. So just starting in on part A, the first thing we want to do is get a complete force diagram for this block. So there's our force diagram, just leaving everything symbolic for now. And I see the force of gravity pulling down on this block that has a magnitude of mg. Here's the normal force pushing up on the block. And because there are no other forces tampering with the vertical direction in this problem, the normal force is just going to be equal to mg, guaranteeing that my net vertical force is zero. In other words, the normal force is expressing the fact that the block is constrained to the surface. And so there's our tension pulling to the right. Now I've shown it as a force vector. And there's our friction force resisting the direction of the sliding by pushing to the left on the block. Now that kinetic friction force is given by mu k, the coefficient of kinetic friction, times n, the size of the normal force. We already figured out the size of the normal force, so I'm going to write mu k mg. And now we could go ahead and get a number on the kinetic friction force. We were told in the problem that the kinetic friction coefficient is 0.3. So I have 0.3 times the mass of the block here, 10.5 kilograms, times 9.8 meters per second squared. And this gives us about 30.9 newtons. Now to find the acceleration of the block, we just apply Newton's second law here. So F net equals MA. Well, this means the acceleration of the block is F net divided by the mass. So A equals F over M is a good way to remember Newton's second law. And our net force here, we're going to use the standard coordinate system where rightward is positive. So I have 68 newtons pulling to the right. That's our tension in the rope. I have 30.9 newtons pushing to the left. That's our kinetic friction force. And then the mass of the block was 10.5 kilograms. And we arrive at an acceleration of about 3.53 meters per second squared. Okay, so what about part B where we're pulling up at an angle? Let's just start by throwing all the forces into the diagram. So there we are with all the force vectors. And of course, what we're gonna have to do to that tension vector is decompose it into horizontal and vertical components. Now the horizontal component, that's going to be responsible for accelerating this block to the right, but the vertical component can't be ignored. That's tampering with the vertical direction and that actually changes the normal force. Okay, so there's our components of the force exerted by the rope here, the tension of 68 newtons, and that breaks down into T cosine 40 degrees for the horizontal component and T sine 40 degrees for the vertical component. Now again, we want to find the kinetic friction force and we know that's related to the normal force. So we kind of have to start by getting that normal force nailed down. And to do this, we have to look at a force analysis in the vertical direction. So we know the normal force will do whatever it has to guarantee that our net force vertically is zero to keep the block constrained to the surface. Well, this time we have three vertical forces acting on our block. Upward, we have the normal force plus T sine of 40 degrees. And that better be equal to our downward force of mg. So this means our normal force is going to be mg minus t sine 40 degrees. I'll go ahead and just throw in numbers at this point. So mg, that's 10.5 times 9.8 meters per second squared minus t sine 40. So 68 newtons times the sine of 40 degrees. And this gives us a normal force of 59.2 newtons. Now we can go back and figure out what that kinetic friction force is. So Fk is given by mu k times the normal force. Again, our coefficient of kinetic friction is 0.3. Our normal force was about 59.2 newtons. And this gives us about 17.8 newtons for the friction force. So notice that the friction force is less in this case, and it's because that upward component of the tension that we're applying to the block, that's reducing the normal force. So that upward component is partially canceling the weight of the block. The normal force doesn't have to do as much to guarantee that the block stays constrained to the surface. So that's getting smaller. And the smaller normal force results in a smaller kinetic friction force. So you might think if the friction force is smaller, the acceleration must be bigger, but it's not that simple because now the force to the right on this block is only a component of the tension. So let's look at our horizontal analysis of forces, our acceleration, is going to be F net over M. And our rightward force is now just a component of the tension, T cosine 40. our leftward force is this kinetic friction force, and I'll just call that FK for a second, and then we're dividing by the mass of the block. So we throw in the numbers, and this time we end up with an acceleration of 3.27 meters per second squared. So it actually turns out to be a little bit slower acceleration, even though the friction force was significantly less. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.